Hello guys, welcome to a new video where I will talk about the best features of Mapstruct, the 5 best features to handle all the cases you can imagine. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel and let's see them. I've already made a video about Mapstruct, about how to integrate it to a Spring Boot application, about how to add the plugin to IntelliJ and the basic usage. And today I will show some more advanced features. Let's start with the easiest one, the constants. It may sound useless, but I don't know how many times I've created an entity like a user which has an initial state of created with 0 items, with 0 messages. All those are constants. But what happens when the constant is not a primitive or a string? What happens when the constant comes from an object, from an enum? I need to import this object. Here is the definition of the created constant. This way, the class specified here will be added in the import of the resulting mapper implementation. Let's go now with another feature, the Java expressions. Sometimes a plain mapping is not enough. Sometimes I need a little or a big adjustment, an adjustment that can be made in Java. Inside this Java expression, I can specify all the Java code I want, but I must be sure to add the necessary imports as before. Another warning is that now the dot notation doesn't work. I must use the getters and setters. Another feature that I use a lot with the Java expressions is the usage of the default methods of the interfaces. Okay, it's not a Mapstruct feature, but it's very useful in this case. As I said, I use the Java expressions sometimes for small adjustments, but sometimes big adjustments fit better inside its own method. As I am in an interface, I can create a default method and call it from the Java expression. In this case, I don't need to specify the imports explicitly, as the code will remain in the interface and not in the implementation. Let's now take a look at the implementation class for the next feature. All the mappings are done at the top, but I'm not sure about the order. What if one field depends on another? Which can be very important if I use the Java expressions. I may use a target field in a Java expression to fill another one. For that, I have the depends on which forks the sequence. I can specify that a value must be filled after another one. And the last feature that I want to show is the mapping target annotation. As we saw before, the first thing Mapstruct does is create the target object, a new and empty object. But what if I need to update an existing one? With the annotation mapping target, I pass as input parameter the object that must receive the data. This way, the data which is already set will continue there. With this mapper, I want to update only some fields. The rest must remain as it was. I want to protect these fields. Those were 5 features I use for some complex mapping with Mapstruct. If you think I've missed someone, add a comment. Don't forget to click on the like button and subscribe to my channel to support my work. And see you in another video. Bye!